I welcome you to the part 4 of the video series of CorelDRAW, and in this video we are going to extend what we did in the part 3 of the video. Remember, we tried drawing shapes and we have only taken these three shapes from the toolbar, and we looked up to the very core property of a vector object, and that was filling color inside it and changing the outline color as well as the thickness of the outline. Now, can we do more with it? That's the question, and yes, we can do. Now, I have zoomed it a little so that you can see it better. And in one of the previous part of the video, I talked about these options which we receive in the option bar in context to our selection. And right now, this rectangle is selected and we have a lot of options available here. So let's just, you know, see what are those options and what we can do with them. Now, the very first option talks about the X and Y position of this object. We also need to understand the referencing system in CorelDRAW, which always accounts the origin of the object. Now, here, in this case, the 0,0 point of the object happens to be in the center, and that we can understand by looking at this gizmo here. And the object origin, yes, you just hover your cursor on top of it and will let you know, set the reference point to the use when positioning or scaling the object, and it is in the center by default. Okay, so X and Y value, that means from this point, this particular point is 108.849 mm, and from the top of the page, this object center is at a distance of 143.245 mm. So, you know, I'm very sorry for making it technical for you people, but I couldn't resist telling you these hidden features, and sometimes these are very, very handy and useful, and you'll realize when you become an expert in CorelDRAW. This defines the width of the selected objects. In this case, it is a rectangle, and I can, you know, let's just, you know, round it off by putting 140, and you see the change occurred in the object as well, and I will just round it off by putting 120 mm. Fine. Now, the changes we have done also shows of the reduction in percentage, and we can also basically reduce the size in percentage. So if I lock this, which locks the aspect ratio of these two, that means I will not be able to distort the image, distort this particular rectangle while changing the width of this object. So if I type 100 mm here, notice the height of the object also got scaled, and we see the change in the percentage value of both of them. So the width of the object reduced to 70.5% and the height of the object got reduced to 71.5%. Now, I you know, really made it complicated so far. I'll keep it very simple from now on. So this is the rectangle, and after that we have rotation settings. I can put in a value, let's say that I want to rotate it, you know, this is right now in a landscape orientation. I want to make it portrait. I'll just type 90 and it switches to a landscape orientation. I can go back by hitting 0. Okay, I can also put 45 degrees rotation, so this controls the rotation of the object. I'll spring it back to 0, and after that we have two options here: mirror horizontally and mirror vertically. These two options will be moot at this point of time because it is a rectangle and it is a uniform object. So even if I do a mirror horizontal, it's not going to do any difference to the object. Now, after that, we have these three options which are very, very important and useful, and people use it all the time in their designs. The very first option talks about round corner. If you wish to read about this, you just hover your cursor on top of it and keep it there. Then you have scalloped corner and you have chamfered corner. So by default, it is set to round corner. It is set to round corner, but we don't see it round actually here. Yeah, because there is no curvature value given to it. And these four represents four corners of the rectangle. Now, these options you are only get when you are using the rectangle tool, because it is a geometric object. In the next part of the video, I'll cover the difference between a geometric vector object, which is created by default tools in the toolbar, or the curves, the vector objects which are converted into curves, because these options which you see right now in the option bar will not be available for the curve. For instance, I'll just quickly show you. If I convert this rectangle into a curve by hitting Ctrl Q on the keyboard, those options will go away and I have no longer control over the corner of the rectangles. I'll just say Ctrl Z to get back to those options, and I'll show you what I mean when I say round corner. And by default, all these four corners will be locked, and I can, you know, if I change the value in one of the corners, let's say that I want a curvature of 10 mm, notice all the fields got the value simultaneously and we have a uniform curvature applied to the corners of the rectangle. Okay, you can also break the link and then individually control. So if I want 30 mm curvature here and here, I want it to be sharp, so I'll put 0. Okay, and let's say that here also I want to have a curvature of 30 mm. I can do so. So I can create very interesting shapes just by manipulating these options here. Alright, now I can also switch to scalloped, which immediately turns the curvature and inverts it. So again, we can get very interesting shapes like that. And after that, we have Samford corner, which again takes up the value from these four fields and apply it in a Samford corner style. Okay, after that, we have option of picking up the width, the thickness of the stroke or the outline, and we have seen it already and we can still change it. So I can reduce the thickness, I can increase the thickness and so on. And after that we have wrapping style, which we will cover later on when we will start putting text into our layout. Right now there is no text, so we are not applying any wrapping style to this particular object we have created. And this option is for converting the object into curve, and then we will no longer have access to these properties. So we will see to that what is the importance of converting into curve and when do we have to do it. Alright, so that was about the rectangle. Now I'm going to show you the ellipse, and we'll create a circle. For creating circle, hold Ctrl and Shift both. Control for constraining the proportion, Shift for originating it from the center, and I can additionally of course hit P anytime to center it on the page. Now I'll just quickly fill up a color into it and then define an outline color as well. Increase the thickness of the outline for better visibility and look at the options in the option bar. Now these two things remain same because Corel perceives a circle also as an object which can be defined by width and height, unlike the regular geometry we have read in the class, which tells that a circle has a radius. Yes, it does have a radius, but it also has height and width, and that is how computer programs perceives a circle in the first place, at least CorelDRAW. So it is defined in terms of width and height, and if width and height are same and the curvature is 100%, then we get a circle. Alright, so we can rotate it of course in the similar fashion like we rotate the rectangle, but in this case it wouldn't make any sense at all. Again, mirroring it is not going to make much sense. Now these three options you should look at, and it says ellipse, pi, it will automatically truncate it to 270 degree value, and then we have an arc, and we can control these. Alright, and we can change the direction of the arc as well, or the pi, or the circle. In this case we do not have the option of changing the direction. Now I can click on the pi and I can put in the value exactly what I want. Let's say that I want a pi of 120 degrees, so I can get that pi and I can reverse it exactly, right? So these two values will define, let's say that I want it to be 50 degrees, see. So it will add it that 50 degrees into the other direction. I can switch it, toggle it anytime I want. Fine. So just play around with it a little and it would reveal what it is to you on its own. It's not that difficult to get. Then we have arc, and arc restrains the similar settings and similar behavior. So that is very much about the circle or ellipse tool. I'll create polygon now, and same way I'll hold control and shift both of them and then create it. And I have limited options, but I must tell you it is a very powerful tool. When I'll tell you that there are more ways of manipulating the shape of these three default geometric vector objects which is given in CorelDRAW. It's not only the option bar which gives us the control over the object, but we have another tool which we will explore in the next part of the video, the shape tool, the almighty shape tool. So wait for it. Right now I'll show you how we can add more sides to the polygon. I can simply click on this up button here to increase the number of sides or decrease the number of sides. I can go as less as 3. Below that it wouldn't be a polygon. Alright, and we also have option of mirroring it. So if it is a regular polygon, mirroring it wouldn't make any difference at all. We all know that. So I have set it to hexagon, and I can change the thickness of it. I can fill the color inside it, and you know, I can, you know, place text wrapping settings, which we will see later on when we deal with text. Okay, so that's pretty much about polygon. All right, I'll just delete it. And I'll show you a couple of more things which I want you to try out, because you know, covering all of them are going to make this video very long, and I don't want to do that. Now this rectangle tool, and there is this 3-point rectangle tool. Now there is the difference between these two tools, but not in the result, but the method they are approaching for creating a rectangle. And this tool is also very handy. I'll just give you example of these and then leave you rest to explore on your own, because you also have a 3-point ellipse, and you also have a couple of more tools which you can explore simply just by creating the shape and looking at the options in the option bar. So I am not going to kill all of your surprises with this software. Okay, so a rectangle, the normal rectangle which we have, and then we have 3-point rectangle. Now what this 3-point rectangle does, it lets you define 3 different points. So this will define the first point, the second point, and imagine this line getting extruded into a shape of rectangle when I click next. You must be thinking, why to click thrice when we can get a rectangle by clicking twice? Your question is very legitimate. But now I'll give you a situation. Let's say that I am supposed to create a rectangle in between these two rectangles. All right. Now how I copied it, I'll tell you about it in upcoming sessions of this video series. So don't worry about it, because I can copy it like this, and I'm doing it with just one hand without pressing any shortcut keys. I'll tell you about it. It's very interesting, and it only happens in CorelDRAW. So right now let's just focus on our objective in understanding the 3-point rectangle tool. And if you have the problem of creating a rectangle in between these two rectangles, it seems fairly simple. You start with here and you end it here, and job is done. Yes, all done. Now imagine if you have a situation like this and you need to create a rectangle in between them. So addressing this situation with the conventional rectangle tool is very difficult. I cannot draw a rectangle which exactly fits in between these two rectangles. So I'll switch to 3-point rectangle tool. I'll start here and then do it like this, and solves our purpose. So that's the beauty of having a different method of creating the same shape. Same way you can also explore 3-point ellipse tool, and in the similar fashion you just go and then dive into these tools and then see it for yourself what they do. Make sure the moment you create it, look at the option bar and just play around with the options. All the best exploring these tools to you. That will be all for this video. See you in the next part. Thank you.